incredible healers that are incredibly benevolent. Unfortunately, most of them are getting a bad rap right now because of what the grays are doing. And you know, there are 5 different subspecies of grays.
May I interject here for a moment? I've heard the phrase long nose gray describing their physical characteristics.
Those are not the benevolent reticulants.
Okay.
The benevolent reticulants look like children.
So the non-benevolent ones are the long nose grays?
That's correct.
That's what I thought.
That's correct.
Okay.
And you know, there's a lot of information that's being, some people are experiencing real benevolent experiences with them, or they're told that they're experiencing benevolent, when in fact they really haven't. They just maybe haven't been regressed or taken deeply into their subconscious to know what is happening. They're incredible masters of mind manipulation. But anyway, their race is dying. They have been so genetically altered by the Orion group that they cannot reproduce. So they were told by the Orion group to come down in here, to come in here, this is how it's been related to me, to come in here and set the stage to break down the social structures so that when the Orion group and the Draconians come back, there are 2 classes, royalty and workers, which is exactly what they're doing.
You can see that agenda happening right in the United States since the beginning of the Reagan administration.
This is where the focus has been. Right. Has been on the United States, singly. And there's been a reason for that, which we'll cover in just a little bit, but let me get my thoughts out here. Which is exactly what the Grays have been told to do. And they're doing it. In the meantime, they themselves have their own agenda. They see us because of our genetic stock of having the DNA of 22 different races and the racial memories of trying to breed, to cross the genetic bridge so that they as a race can have enough genetic stock to continue to propagate their race, which according to the Andromedans, they're destined for extinction. What they're doing is not going to have any long-term effects to propagate their race. So they're desperately trying to do what it is that they're trying to do before all the other 2 groups get here. The Grays also themselves want to be free from the manipulation of the Orion group, just like we as a race want to be free of their manipulation. So there's this incredible triangle of crap that's hanging all over us, you know, and all these hidden agendas and brainwashing and bizarre belief systems that are being thrown at us, you know, when they should all leave. Not only the good ones and the bad ones, they should all just leave and leave us alone, which is ultimately what the Andromedans want. But unfortunately, that isn't going to happen right now, not until some changes occur.
We have to begin to raise our consciousness.
Right, we need to. And the first thing we need to do is we need to stop warring with each other. We need to come together as a race, and no matter what happens, we need to stop all of the political garbage and say, look, when it comes down to the bottom line, all we have is each other as a race, period. And this is our planet, this is our home, and there's enough of us that are polluting the planet that we need to stop. Because if we don't stop polluting the planet, Rick, we're not going to have a place to live. Period.
Is there an Earth quarantine that the renegade Zeta Reticulans violated?
Yes.
And what was that quarantine?
The quarantine was they were supposed to... Well, it's the same quarantine that evolves, that any other evolving planet has. No intervention with an evolving race. But because of our genetic stock, the Grays did it. Now, but they did it in such a way that they didn't totally violate our free will. You know, they dangled a technological carrot to the government. And the government took the bait. They said, sure, you know, for their own reasons, they took the bait. And there was an exchange of technology, you know, and there was a treaty that was signed. And this is a dilemma that the Andromedan Council has. You know, if the United States military had said, go away, the Grays would have had to have left.
So was this the Air Force Base situation or the Eisenhower situation where he had representatives? Is this the one that took place in the 50s?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. And this was with the Long Nose Grays
then? That's true. And there were 2 groups there as well. The 17 Syrians from Sirius B who are still here were also witnesses to this to add credence to it.
Okay.
So...
Now...
And there are also, now, just to add to this, the Andromedans have also said that in 1933, when the Greys really first got here, that they had actually approached the Germans. And the Germans said, no, you're out of here. We already have an agreement, and apparently the Germans were in touch with Giza intelligence. So the Greys left. They didn't pursue it at all. And they found their next opening here in the United States.
Let's go digress just a moment. You mentioned Sirius B. They have a relationship with the Dogon tribes in Africa, correct? Is that correct?
Yes, I understand that there is some ancestral genetic connection there.
Okay. Does that play a part in what's going on here on a global level, or is that just a kind of a minor sidelight?
I don't think at this point they give a damn about the Dogons or the humans at all. They all have their own agendas. And the fact that the way we're being treated, and the fact that there's like no supportal information coming out of our government, or any truth that they even want to discuss, like just coming to the people and saying, look, folks, we screwed up. We need your help. We need to raise a consciousness and start implementing. The fact that they don't even want to do that, you know, tells you really, you know, where they're at. What I do know about the Syrians is that between Sirius A and Sirius B, there is a civil war going on there. And a lot of that, and there are also 21 other systems. There's war going on in Perseus as we speak. And 21 other star systems are also looking at the potential. And it has to do with the fact that there is now an uplifting of energy in our universe that's occurring. And the two positives, fear and love, are just banging themselves at each other. And the intensity is growing. Is growing every single moment.
So as
and we're just a microcosm of that.
Now, as you're disseminating all this information to us, we should look at all this information in the spirit of love, so we don't feed any energy into the spirit of fear.
Love is the answer. That's the bottom line. Love is the answer. Love does conquer all. Love does move mountains. It can make the shifts in consciousness, but it starts, number one, with ourselves. You know,
so
that's
even all this is going on around us, we just need to remember to focus on love and
love of self and love of earth, love of race. That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
Now, when did the Zeta Reticulans begin to create their genetic atrocities? Where did this take place on Earth, and what have the results been?
Well, it's occurring everywhere. Much of it is occurring underground. Some of it's occurring in the oceans. Some of it's occurring on the moon. Some of it's occurring on Phobos, the moon of Mars. It's happening in a lot of different places.
Is that an artificial moon?
Yes, it's absolutely. So is our moon. Our moon's artificial, completely artificial. It was brought here from Ursa Minor, apparently between 11 and 12,000 years ago.
For the purpose of?
Of being a satellite and a base, which, you know, they evacuated some time ago, but it's now being operational again. And I cover this in the series of eight. It came from a star system called Chata. Well, that's for a word, that's the word they use, Chata. And it was the 17th planet out of a solar system that had 21 planets, and it was one of four moons. And it was brought here. It is older than the Earth. There are ruins all over it. There are bases underneath it. It's everything that we're told it isn't.
Okay.
So that's a whole unique story unto itself.
Okay, now, what are the results of these atrocities, these genetic atrocities, been? And are we going to begin to see more of them appearing?
Well, the Greys are trying to create a sub-race that is a blend between human culture, the human race, and their race.
A kind of a hybrid sit.
Exactly. They're not being very, very successful. And one of the things that they're trying to do is they're really looking for the soul. They don't understand the soul. They don't understand our extremes of emotions as well, because they're very, very different from us. Their experiments haven't been all that successful. There are a lot of emotional problems with that, with what they're doing. Because what really makes a human being, is our essence, is the spirit that animates the physical form. Well, there's also another factor. and that is that they actually feed off the energy. They're vampires.
The Zeta Reticulan Gray.